So in this tutorial, I am going to show you that how you can create this animated shark in PowerPoint 2016. So stay tuned as I will be right back. Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. And first of all, I would like to tell you that if you don't use Selection Pane, then I must advise you that you should use it, because when you have multiple objects on your slide, then it will be very hard for you to select or animate particular objects. As you can see that here I have a lot of objects in the Selection Pane, and if I expand these groups, then you can see further more objects within these groups. And if you don't rename these items in the Selection Pane, then it will be very hard for you to select and animate particular objects in your slide. So you can also watch my video on how to use Selection Pane in Microsoft Office. So let's get started with this shark animation. So first of all, I am gonna animate the tail of the shark, and for that I am going to use animation, add animation, more motion paths, and here I am going to apply right motion path. Hit the OK button and adjust the path length. You can zoom in a little bit by holding the control key and then use the mouse wheel to scroll in and out, and hold down the shift key when you need to resize the paths. That way the path will go straight. And I would like to move it just right here. And here is a little bit problem in PowerPoint, where when you try to resize the path length by holding the shift key, if you go a little bit near to the starting point, then it just drag the ending point over the starting point. So you have to manually adjust the path without the shift key. So I would like to move this tail just right here. Now open the animation pane from the animations tab. Click the animation pane button and adjust the size. And I no longer require this selection pane, so I am gonna close it. So here what I need to do, I want this tail to animate when I play the slideshow automatically, and for that I am gonna use with previous option, and I would like to apply a duration of around half a second. Now open the effect option, and you can open the effect option by double clicking on an effect, or you can also open effect options by right clicking on the effect and choose effect options. And here I would like to auto reverse this effect, so the tail will move to the right and will auto reverse back to its original position. And I would also like to apply a smoothness of 0.25 seconds for both start and end. And in the timing tab, I want to repeat this animation until the end of the slide. Hit the OK button. Let me short the path length a bit. As you can see that when I move the path, it automatically moves the ending part over the starting part. That is a problem in the PowerPoint. That's nice. Now I want to animate the fin, so I select this one and go to animation, add animation, click spin and start with previous, and would like to apply a duration of around 1 second, and open the effect options. I would like to rotate this fin to 10 degree counterclockwise, and would like to auto reverse the fin back to its original position, and would like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. That's nice. Let me show you the slideshow. As you can see that the tail and fin both are moving now. Now it's time to move the eyes. We have 4 different parts in the eyes, and they have not been grouped together because I want to animate these 3 parts, yellow, black and white part. So I have not grouped these eye parts together. So first of all, I will animate the yellow part, and for that I go to the add animation, more motion paths, and apply the right motion path. Hit the OK button. Zoom out a little bit by holding the control and then use the mouse wheel. As you can see that as I am zooming in by holding the control and mouse wheel, then it is not zooming over the eye because it is not selected. So you must remember one thing, that if I select this eye and now if I use control and mouse wheel to zoom in, then it will automatically zoom to that particular selected part. So you must remember this. Just like I select this water wave, and if I now zoom in, then it will automatically zoom in to the selected object. Now I am going to adjust the path length of this yellow eye. I just want to move it right here. Okay, and now change the effect options, and for eye I want to repeat this animation until end of the slide, and I also want to auto reverse this effect with a bit smoothness here, and want to start it with previous repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. Okay, let me remove the smoothness here and set the duration to around 1 second. That's fine. Now I want to apply the same animation to the blue, or you can say black. Let me change the color of this one to black. Yellow and black and white have the same animation with a bit difference in the timing. So I select the yellow one and want to apply the same animation to the black and white part. So I select the yellow part and go to the animations tab and then click animation painter once, and then click on the black part, and it will automatically apply the same animation to the black part as well. Now as you can see that the black part is selected, and I want to apply the same animation to the white one. So I click the animation painter and then click on the white part, and here you have the same animation on the white part as well. And you can have the same duration and same delay timing, or you can change the delay timing a bit. Like I can add 0.5 second delay to the black part and 0.10 second delay to the white part. So it is up to you that how you want to animate these part of the eyes. And now it's time to animate the waves. And for that I will apply the left motion path and then change the path length. Okay, I want to play it with previous with a duration of 1 second. Open the effect options. I would like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. And I also want to fade out this wave when it moves to the left. For that I will apply fade exit effect with previous with a duration of 1 second and no delay timings, and also like to repeat this animation until end of the slide, and also want to remove the delay timing from this motion path. Let's see the slideshow. Okay, that's fine. And now I am going to apply the same animation to all the waves. So instead of clicking animation painter again and again, what you can do, you can double click on the animation painter and then start clicking on the other waves. That way it will apply the same animation on all the waves. That's fine. Now let's see the slideshow. As you can see that all waves are moving together. So what you can do, you can add the delay timing between the waves, and for that select each group of the waves and add a delay timing, like 0.25 second for this one and half a second for this one and 0.15 for this one. Sorry, I have selected wrong groups. 0.25 for this one, half a second for this one, 0.15 for this one, 0.75 for this one, and no delay timing for this one. Now let's see the slideshow. Okay, the last thing is to move the water wave below, and for that I will apply the same motion path to the left. Hit the OK button, and what you need to do, you need to adjust the path length, and I will drop it just right here. Set it to play with previous with a duration of around 3 seconds. Open the effect options. Don't want any smoothness for this one. No auto reverse, but like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Okay, now let's see the final preview. So I hope you will like this short tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below, and don't forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon, so whenever I will upload a new tutorial, you will get a notification on your mobile or desktop. Thanks for watching and have a great day.